So last time we started with digital control systems. I enlisted the number of advantages associated with digital control systems and also the disadvantages associated with these systems. So just summarizing, the digital control system, it's more flexible. You can modify the system easily. You can implement advanced control schemes like AI, MPCs, SMCs, extra very easily using digital control or microcontrol circuitry. Fine. It allows us to integrate various control actions like optimization, planning, scheduling, maintenance, extra. We can also implement number of control loops easily using the digital control system. Its efficiency is high. It will offer better support for multiple input, multiple output systems. And it also is cheaper. And as the complexity of the control circuit increases, the cost of digital control system basically reduces proportionally as compared to its analog counterpart. There are some disadvantages that is because of the process of quantization and sampling. Once you convert an analog signal to digital signal, that results in loss of information. That information that we'll be losing is something that we need to take care about, and it will offer, there will be certainly some loss of information. No matter what, this information will be lost, and you have to make ways to fix it. Now we'll look at the topology or the configuration of a digital control system. So a typical topology of a computer control system will be shown like this. There'll be number of configurations. Fine. You can have a configuration like this. So you can have one configuration like this, where this part will represent your control circuitry. Fine. So in a digital control system, since your input may be an analog signal, you will have, and your measured signal will also be an analog signal. Fine. So both these signals here, this will be analog signal, this will be an analog signal. So first to So this will be an analog signal. So first, to basically be able to, for the microcontroller or for the PC to read this signal, you will have to convert it into a digital signal. So you'll be using analog to digital converters. Fine. So there are a number of analog to digital converters that you may have studied in digital control, in digital electronics. So we can use those ADCs for converting our analog signal to digital signal. And once we have the digital signal, the microcontroller will be able to process this information, accordingly give us the desired output. And that desired output will again be a digital signal that will be processed by the DAC, the digital to analog controller, to give us an analog signal. which will go to the actuator and the plant for control action. Fine. So we can have a configuration like this. This part, ADC, microcontroller, and DAC, will represent the control part. And you may also, this may be clock driven. Fine. As you know, microcontrollers, they are basically clock driven. So accordingly, you will be having a clock for maintaining the synchronization between all these three, ADC, the microcontroller, and the DAC. You can have, this can be one configuration, or another configuration can be this can be another configuration wherein your input is also a digital signal. Fine. So we can basically set the reference within the PC. PC may hum change kar sakte hain. We can set any reference point within the PC for our system to be controlled. And like say for example in case of an air conditioner, say for example, we are setting a digital signal there. We set it to 25 degree, to set it to 26 degree. So that's actually a digital signal already getting processed within the system. In other cases, you may have a potentiometer outside, जिससे आप knob change कर रहे हो, जिससे आप reference signal change कर रहे हो, उसको that will be an analog signal that you have to then convert first into a digital signal. So another configuration can be that your reference input can also be a digital signal, but your measured output is an analog signal. So you need to convert this into digital signals first. So that we can compare this. Now we can directly feed it to the microcontroller or the PC for processing, then to the DAC for converting it back into the analog signal. Fine. Then this analog signal can go to the actuator and the plant configuration for processing this information. Now in this case, what is different from that of an analog control system? यहाँ पे सेंसर्स वहाँ पे भी है, यहाँ पे भी सेंसर्स है, वहाँ पे भी एक्चुएटर था, प्लांट था, वहाँ पे भी आपका कंट्रोलर था. दैट कंट्रोलर वॉज एन एनालॉग डिवाइस. इफ़ यू हैव अ पीआई कंट्रोलर, यू कैन डिज़ाइन अ प्रोपोर्शनल कंट्रोलर यूजिंग ऑप एम्प. यू कैन डिज़ाइन एन इंटीग्रल कंट्रोलर यूजिंग एन ऑप एम्प. सो यू कैन हैव अ प्रोपोर्शनल पीआई कंट्रोलर डिज़ाइन यूजिंग वेरियस एनालॉग डिवाइसेस. इट कैन बी ऑप एम्प्स, इट कैन बी सिंपल ट्रांजिस्टर्स एक्स्ट्रा. So you can use those devices, analog devices, to create a controller. But now here we have the controller is a PC or a microcontroller, a microprocessor. This is a digital device, and for that you need to have two more elements associated with it. One is the ADC and the DAC. Okay? So ADC is not just a combination of an analog to digital device. It may also have these may also have sampling and hold circuits, zero order hold circuits associated with them. Fine. So in this configuration, if we list the input, various devices, you have the, you will have the input, you will have an ADC, you will have a microcontroller or microprocessor. You will have a DAC, you will have the plant and the actuator. Sensors. So these are two configurations. I'll show another third configuration as well. So इसमें आपके पास ADC और DAC, these are extra. ऑन द नॉर्मल एनालॉग कंट्रोल सिस्टम वहाँ पर ना तो आपको एनालॉग टू डिजिटल कन्वर्जन की जरूरत थी, ना तो डिजिटल एनालॉग की जरूरत थी. कंट्रोलर वहाँ पर भी था, यहाँ पर अब वहाँ पर एनालॉग कंट्रोलर था, यहाँ पर अब डिजिटल कंट्रोलर है. डैट कैन बी ए माइक्रो कंट्रोलर और माइक्रो प्रोसेसर. Third configuration can be you can use As we have discussed observers can be implemented using digital devices. You can design an observer is basically simply a state space model of the plant that gives us the estimate of various states of the system that can help us measure the system states using the knowledge of input and output. That knowledge of input and output can be fed to the system using ADCs. So once we have that information, then the observers will be used to measure or sense the value of the output here that's in question, right? So in this case it is different from the second configuration kyunki wahan pe sensor aapko analog input, it was giving you an analog input and you had to process it and get a digital output, while as in this case you are using an observer will use Observer will be using a digital input that will be actually processed for the microcontroller to take certain control action, and this observer will receive this information from the ADC. ठीक है, तो सेंसर आपको एनालॉग आउटपुट दे रहा है, एनालॉग इनपुट जा रहा है सेंसर को, एनालॉग आउटपुट मिल रहा है ऑब्जर्वर को, आपको डिजिटल इनपुट जा रहा है एंड यू आर गेटिंग अ डिजिटल आउटपुट. बट अगेन यू कैन ऑल्सो डिजाइन एन ऑब्जर्वर यूजिंग एनालॉग डिवाइसेज, बट दैट इज मोर less likely as compared to using a microcontroller or a microprocessor for processing this information, right? So these are three different configurations that you can use for implementing a digital control system. In all of these three configurations, the thing is that you have two extra devices, one is the ADC and the DAC, right? Now among this ADC and DAC, ADC is more important because ADC is slower as compared to DAC. ADC is basically a two-step process, while as DAC is a single-step process. DAC will directly give you digital to analog output, but ADC, it requires two steps. One is the quantization and another one is the sampling. ठीक है, तो इसमें दो steps involved होते हैं. So this is much slower. So this ADC will basically determine the time taken for this whole configuration. It will actually, क्योंकि ये स्लो जा रहा है, बाकी सारे सिस्टम्स भी बाकी सारे पार्ट्स भी सिस्टम में स्लो जाएंगे. ठीक है, तो ए डी सी विल बेसिकली डिटरमाइन वॉट विल बी द टाइम, एंड इफ यू प्रॉपरली चूज द सैम्पलिंग टाइम अकॉर्डिंगली आपकी प्रोसेसिंग स्पीड भी वैसी होगी. ठीक है, so this is about the configurations. Now as far as ADC and DACs go, you have actually studied them, you have studied the R2R ladders and other different types of ADCs and similarly DACs. As I was saying, this ADC one, it will have to sample the information, sampler will be used, and you will have to use a quantizer as well as an encoder. ठीक है, so quantizer and encoder can be simultaneously implemented. So यहाँ पे एक एनालॉग सिग्नल जा रही है, दिस एनालॉग सिग्नल विल बी कंटिन्यूअस टाइम सिग्नल. ठीक है, सो जो कंटिन्यूसली वैरी हो रही है विद रेस्पेक्ट टू टाइम and is also defined for each and every value of time. Here you will be having a discrete time after a sampler. We'll be having a discrete time continuous amplitude signal. Okay. So it will be defined for discrete values of time after a sampler, but the amplitude will be continuously varying still with respect to time. Fine. Now after a quantizer, what you'll be having is discrete time. Discrete amplitude signal. This will be simply a digital signal. So you have a continuous time signal that is varying with respect to time, as well as its amplitude is varying with respect to time. It is defined for each and every value of time. After a sampler, you will be having a discrete time signal, okay? So randomly, but it will be, that means it is defined at this point, it is defined at this point, it is defined at this point, but it is still continuously varying with respect to time. So there is no fixed levels, fine? While as a discrete time, discrete amplitude signal means, it will be defined for all discrete values of time, and it will be taking certain fixed values only. Okay, so here 2 lega, 4 lega, it can be 6. It will not be taking any other value between 4 and 6. In this case, it will be, say for example, 2.5, 2.7, 2.8. So it's still defined, its amplitude is still varying, it is continuously varying. But as far as after the quantizer, what happens is your signal is basically quantized to certain levels. It will be taking certain levels only, say for example 2, 4, 6, or you can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are fractions, wo ab aapke gayab ho jayenge. And ultimately, the digital signal will simply be its digital equivalents 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, ya phir 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, whatever. Jitni aapki word length hai, आपका प्रोसेसर जिस हिसाब से डिफाइंड है उसी हिसाब से, ठीक है? तो यू आर मूविंग, यू विल बी हैविंग 4 डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सिग्नल्स इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ एडीसी. फाइन. नाउ व्हेन यू विल बी बेसिकली यूजिंग अ डीएसी, व्हाट विल बी डूइंग इज डिकोडर एंड एनकोडर बेसिकली इज टेक्स ओनली actually combined with the system, and that's why we say ADC is a two-step process and DAC is a single-step process. Fine. So DAC mein ab aapke paas kya hoga, you will have a digital signal. Digital signal means you'll be having either 0001 1011, something like that. You will then be decoding it to discrete time signal. Now at this point, the signal will be automatically discrete in time as well as discrete with respect to amplitude. Okay? So it will be taking certain fixed values only. 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. Fine. Fractions may not happen. Because once you are converting from this type of signal to this type of signal, there is binary to decimal, you will not have the information about the fractions. ऐसे ही फिर आपके पास जो अब एनालॉग सिग्नल आ जाएगी बाय यूजिंग जीरो ऑर्डर होल्ड. होल्ड मींस बेसिकली इट विल होल्ड दिस अंटिल द नेक्स्ट सैम्पलिंग टाइम. तो उसके बाद आपके पास एक ऐसी सिग्नल आ जाएगी. तो दिस इज अगेन अ कंटिन्यूस टाइम सिग्नल. दैट मींस इट इज कंटिन्यूसली, इट इज डिफाइंड फॉर ईच एंड एवरी वैल्यू ऑफ टाइम टी. ठीक है. बट अब इसके जो एम्पलीट्यूड होगा दैट विल बी बेसिकली डिस्क्रिटाइज्ड. So this is your analog signal. Analog signal refers to any signal jo har kisi time ke liye defined ho. Discrete signal refers to any signal that is only defined for discrete values of time. You have two classifications. You have analog signal and discrete signal. Continuous time signal is a type of analog signal. Digital signal is a type of discrete time signal. ठीक है, आपके पास बेसिकली दो ही टाइप्स ऑफ सिग्नल्स है. वन इज एनालॉग सिग्नल एंड सेकेंड वन इज डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिग्नल. एनालॉग टाइम सिग्नल में फिर आपके पास या तो ऐसी एक सिग्नल होगी या फिर आपके पास ऐसी एक सिग्नल होगी. ठीक है, वन इज कंटिन्यूस टाइम सिग्नल. दिस इज ऑल्सो कंटिन्यूस टाइम सिग्नल बट सिंस इट इज डिस्क्रीटाइज इट इज नोन एज क्वांटाइज एनालॉग सिग्नल. फाइन, एज फार एज डिस्क्रीट सिग्नल गो यू कैन हैव either a digital signal, that is it will take digital values 0001 या फिर 0000100011 binary values, or you can have this type of signal which is a sampled discrete time signal. Fine, but its magnitude is no longer now it can be either quantized or it cannot be quantized, but its magnitude is not in digital form now. It's not either in binary or in any hexadecimal or something like that. ठीक है, so you have two circuitries here, the analog to digital signal converter and the DAC. Analog to digital signal, it is a three step, it's actually a two step process. One is a sampler and another one is a quantizer. Encoder, without even using the encoder you are still getting a discrete time signal, so encoder is not necessary for the information to be processed. If your system can process with is able to process it, fine. ऐसे DAC आपके पास, इसमें आपके पास एक तो डिकोडर होगा, दूसरा जीरो ऑर्डर होल्ड होगा. होल्ड सर्किट बेसिकली कन्वर्ट्स योर डिजिटल डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिग्नल नाउ इंटू एन एनालॉग सिग्नल बाई होल्डिंग द वैल्यूज ऑफ होल्डिंग द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दिस डिस्क्रीट टाइम सिग्नल फॉर द सैम्पलिंग पीरियड. ठीक है, तो ये इस वैल्यू को होल्ड करेगा इतने टाइम के लिए, इतने टाइम के लिए होल्ड करेगा, इतने टाइम के लिए होल्ड करेगा. Fine, we are getting an analog signal. Analog signal means it is defined for each and every value of time. Now you can use an R2R ladder for digital to analog converter. Aise hi aapne ADCs padhe honge, you may have studied about successive approximation SARs. Theek hai, so you can go back to that and you can see how ADC and DAC basically operates. Now here, as I was saying, since ADC is a two-step process, an ADC will basically determine आपका जो पूरा डिजिटल कंट्रोल सिस्टम है, आपका जो ये डिजिटल सिस्टम है, इसका जो प्रोसेसिंग टाइम है, that will be decided by the ADC because it is it takes more amount of time. Fine. So we are done with the introduction part. We are done with the configuration of a digital control system. We are done with the advantage of a digital control system, the disadvantage of a digital control system. इसमें ADCs है, DACs है, वो थोड़ा बहुत go back to digital electronics and read them, how an ADC works, how a DAC works. I have given you the processes involved in an ADC and a DAC. के बाद जो कॉन्फ़िगरेशन है, फॉर एग्जांपल आई वाज टॉकिंग अबाउट आर टू आर लैडर या सक्सेसिव अप्रोक्सीमेशन, सो यू कैन चेक देम आउट, यू कैन सी हाउ दे फंक्शन. नाउ डिजिटल कंट्रोल सिग्नल्स, फॉर डिजिटल कंट्रोल सिग्नल्स विल बी यूजिंग नाउ जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म. ठीक है, so as far as Z transform, you have studied Z transform hopefully. In analog we were using the Laplace transform, we were analog ke liye humne Laplace transform kiya tha, we were solving the equations in either S domain or T domain. Now as far as digital control goes, we'll be going with the Z transform, so we'll be either solving the equations in Z domain or you can say discrete time domain, that is KT. Fine. So hopefully जैसे आपको, जैसे आपने लैपलास ट्रांसफॉर्म किया था, लैपलास ऑफ बेसिक सिग्नल्स, यू नीड टू, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट. सिमिलरली यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द Z ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ सम बेसिक सिग्नल्स, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल लैपलास ऑफ some basic signals like have, say for example, an impulse, you have unit step input, fine. You have a ramp input, ramp, unit step, impulse. Then you have other types of बाकी और भी जैसे आप टी के साथ मल्टीप्लाई करते हो, यू हैव एन एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन, यू हैव साइन फंक्शन, कोसाइन फंक्शन. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर द लैपलास ऑफ ऑल ऑफ दीज फंक्शन. यू हैव टू ऑल्सो रिमेंबर द जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म ऑफ ऑल ऑफ दीज फंक्शंस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, लैपलास ऑफ द इम्पल्स Laplace of an impulse or Z transform of an impulse function, you can simply say it is 1. Laplace of unit time, unit step input, it is 1 by s. As far as the Z transform of unit step goes, it is Z divided by Z minus 1. Fine. As a Laplace of ramp input, Laplace of t is 1 by s square. यहाँ पे आपका t Z divided by Z minus 1 square है, ठीक है. Laplace of an exponential function, e raised power minus at, 1 by s plus a, ठीक है. So z transform of this is z divided by z minus e raised power minus at. Fine. यहाँ पे t है, these are the sampling times. Now you understand that in digital domain there will be sampling times. So z transform basically is connects, basically gives you the frequency response out, frequency response equivalent of sampled time signals. ठीक है. Laplace transform gives you the frequency response equivalent of continuous time signals. Z transform gives you the frequency response equivalents of sampled time signals. Fine. You have unit step input, you have impulse, you have a ramp input, you have exponential function, you can have sine omega t, sine, say for example, Laplace of sine is sine of at is a divided by s square plus a square. As is z transform is sine of at z divided by z square minus 2 cos t z plus 1. Fine. ऐसे ही cos का, ऐसे ही a raised power k का, ठीक है, z divided by z minus a raised power k, ठीक है. So if there is, instead of having a unit input, you can have unit step input, you can have a. Fine. तो इसका z transform z divided by z minus a, ठीक है. Of unit step input is basically a constant function jiska value 1 hai. Now if it is a step input but having any other magnitude, say for example its magnitude is a, so accordingly aapka jo z transform hai, that will be z divided by z minus a raised power a. Fine. Aise a raised power k ka z divided by z minus a raised power k. ऐसे आपको एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन का बोल दिया, z डिवाइड बाय z माइनस e रेज़ माइनस a t, साइन का, कोसाइन का. सो ऑल दीज वैल्यूज यू कैन फाइंड आउट, यू कैन चेक फ्रॉम योर बुक. ऐसे फिर इनवर्स z ट्रांसफॉर्म, आई होप यू अगेन. सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इज वी हैव टू टेक आउट नाउ एज वी स्टार्टेड इन केस ऑफ एनालॉग सिस्टम्स. हमने वहाँ पे डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन से स्टार्ट किया, डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन का जेड ट्रांसफॉर्म निकाला, वहाँ से फिर हमने वाई एस डिवाइडेड बाई यू एस डिफाइन किया, ठीक है. अब हमारे पास डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन नहीं होगी, हमारे पास अब डिफरेंस इक्वेशन होगी, ठीक है. सो एनालॉग सिस्टम्स, इन एनालॉग सिस्टम्स यू यूज डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस बाय डिफरेंशिएटिंग दैट इक्वेशन. यू कैन गेट by taking the Laplace of that differential equation, you are able to find out ys divided by us, the transfer function. Now in discrete time systems, instead of using, we do not go with differential equation now, we have difference equations here. So difference equations ka hum z transform nikalenge, so we'll be defining yz divided by uz, theek hai? So isko hum pulse transfer function bolte hain. This was simply referred to as the transfer function, right? The transfer function was the ratio of the Laplace of the output to the Laplace of the input for all initial conditions set to zero. Pulse transfer function will be defined as the ratio of the Z transform of the output to the Z transform of the input with all initial conditions set to zero. वहाँ पे आप ये equation differential equation से निकालते थे. For example, d square y by dt square plus dy by dt plus y is equal to u. Fine. Now you will be having difference equations here. Difference equation will be of this form, yk minus 1 plus yk plus yk plus 1 is equal to uk. Okay? So now your outputs will be defined for certain samples where k will represent the samples. K will be 1, 2, 3, 4. So your equation is no longer continuous. Your analog signal is no longer continuous. You're having sampled time signals, and for sampled time signals we will be using Z transform. So in the next session what we'll be doing is we will be starting with the difference equations, we'll be solving the difference equations and getting the pulse transfer function from those difference equations, okay, by using the knowledge of Z transform. So Z transform of various equations, you need to keep them in mind, ठीक है. ऐसे say for example Z transform Laplace of dy by dt, अब तक आपको याद हो गया होना चाहिए. Laplace of dy by dt is sys minus y naught, ठीक है. ऐसे ही अब आपके पास yk minus 1 है. Z transform of yk minus 1, what will be the Z transform of yk minus 1? You will have to study that, fine. You before going into the next session, I wish you go through the basic formulas associated with the Z transform of time scaled functions, time shifted functions, Z transform of exponential functions, Z transform of two functions that are multiplied with each other. Usme kya hoga? By multiplying with respect, say for example, you have a function that's multiplied with t, theek hai, usse kya hota hai? Aise Laplace mein bhi aapko yaad rakhna hai, ab aapko Z transform mein bhi yaad rakhna hai. So now in digital domain, we'll be now going with, we'll be using Z transform to analyze all those equations that we were previously, for which we were using Laplace in the continuous time domain. ठीक है, बाकी फिर analysis same है. वहाँ पे जैसे stability थी यहाँ पे भी वैसी stability होगी, वहाँ पे जैसे controllability थी यहाँ पे भी वही होगा, जहाँ जैसे वहाँ पे observability थी यहाँ पे भी वही होगा. वहाँ पे Rauch-Herbert's table था, यहाँ पे Judy's stability criteria ने, you make the same sort of a table, fine. वहाँ पे differential equation है, यहाँ पे difference equation है. Differential equation and difference equation, how they are related, again I hope you remember that. आपने जब differential equation basically start की होगी 11th class में, dy by dt is yk minus 1 माइनस वाई के डिवाइडेड बाई डेल्टा के, ठीक है. तो ये वाई के माइनस वन कहाँ से आया? ये वहीं से सैम्पलिंग से आया. सो डिफरेंस इक्वेशन एंड डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, दे आर ऑल्सो रिलेटेड टू ईच अदर. आई होप रिमेंबर दैट बेसिक फॉर्मूला अबाउट ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन फ्रॉम योर 11th क्लास, राइट. इफ नॉट, गो बैक टू इट. डी वाई बाई डी टी आप हमने स्टार्ट में कैसे निकाला था वो देख लो आप, यूजिंग फॉर दैट infinitely small amount of time delta t. So that's all for today. Continue in the next session.